Hello and welcome back to Pics and Portraits. When South Park debuted in the late 1990s, it pushed the boundaries of what could be shown on television. It created quite the stir when it premiered and has since gone on to receive numerous accolades, including a Peabody, as well as its fair share of controversy. In this video, we will revisit the height of its popularity, as well as the influence it had not only on television, but society as a whole. The success of The Simpsons proved there was a place on television for adult-oriented animation. While extremely quaint in hindsight, at the time The Simpsons was very controversial. It addressed issues not often discussed on TV and held a huge influence over American culture throughout the 90s. Other networks tried to capitalize on its popularity, and several animated sitcoms emerged in its wake, from Capital Critters to Duckman, though none had The Simpsons' staying power. I believe budget played a role in their failure. Animation is very expensive, but I also feel that many interpreted adult as edgy or risque, or just plain dull, ignoring The Simpsons' heart, its writing. However, by 1997, The Simpsons was beginning to show signs of age. Once its strong suit, the show's writing suffered as storylines became more and more outlandish. It's no surprise that by the 9th season, audiences began tuning out. That same year, South Park premiered on Comedy Central. Now, Comedy Central was synonymous with low-budget, low-quality programming to the point it was literally a punchline in The Simpsons' Who Shot Mr. Burns. It was the result of the merger of two other cable comedy channels, The Comedy Channel and Ha, in 1991. Throughout the 90s, Comedy Central aired mostly licensed content from elsewhere, sitcom reruns, movies, stand-up, and old SNL broadcasts, in addition to some original programming. While a couple of these achieved critical acclaim, none had the effect South Park would. The show's creators, Trey Parker and Matt Stone, met as film students at the University of Colorado. In 1992, they produced the animated short The Spirit of Christmas, or Jesus vs. Frosty. This was animated in a cutout style using construction paper and an 8mm camera. Clearly a predecessor to South Park, it features prototypes of the characters building a snowman. Like Frosty, he magically comes to life, but instead attacks the children, killing Kenny, who is skinned with Cartman's eventual design. They reach out to Santa, and eventually Jesus for help. The savior kills the snowman, and the short ends with one of the children pontificating the meaning of Christmas. Jesus vs. Frosty caught the attention of Fox executive Brian Graydon. Graydon commissioned a short from Parker and Stone he intended to distribute as a video Christmas card. This became The Spirit of Christmas, or Jesus vs. Santa. It is a much more recognizable antecedent to South Park, as the characters are more or less how they appear in the series. It features bits that would be recycled, like Cartman mocking Kyle's Jewish faith, and centers around a showdown between Jesus and Santa to decide the true meaning of Christmas. Jesus vs. Santa was among the first viral videos. Copies were passed around between people in the entertainment industry before drawing the attention of Fox. Parker and Stone wanted to develop it into a series, and Fox expressed interest, but would ultimately pass, learning a character would be a literal piece of shit. However, Comedy Central saw potential in the concept, and given the fact that cable channels can get away with showing more explicit or mature content, decided to give the show a chance. South Park premiered on August 13th, 1997, and became an immediate hit. The first episode drew just shy of a million viewers, but just 3 months later, that number tripled and would steadily increase to the series' peak of 6.2 million viewers. Now, up until this point, I've just kind of assumed you know what South Park is. In case you don't, the show revolves around four children and the misadventures they have in their small mountain town. There is de facto leader, Stan, arguably the most well-adjusted of the group. Token Jew Kyle, whose reactionary, overprotective mother often parodied the show's critics, we'll get there. The show's overweight, hyper-offensive breakout star, Eric Cartman, and poor impoverished Kenny, who died in every episode. You bastards. The situations the children found themselves in range from the absurd, like battling an army of mutant turkeys, to the morbid, helping Stan's grandfather commit suicide. With content like this, it's no shock the series was controversial. It was among the first weekly shows to be rated TVMA, having debuted shortly after the FCC implemented a rating system on television. Similar to the MPAA's production code or the ESRB's rating code in film and gaming, they range from appropriate for all audiences to restricted to adults. These worked in conjunction with a V-chip, a piece of technology built into cable boxes that allowed the blocking of content depending on the rating. In early promos, South Park actually boasted it is the reason the V-chip exists. Still, the show was very popular with the youth. Like The Simpsons, South Park t-shirts were banned from schools, and many organizations came out against the show, claiming it to be offensive and immoral. One of the most vocal critics of South Park was the PTC, or Parents Television Council. The PTC is a conservative advocacy group founded in 1995 whose mission is to bring back family values to the entertainment industry. They have found enemies in Family Guy, The Simpsons, and World Wrestling Entertainment, who actually sued them for defamation. Peggy Charon, founder of the similar group ACT, or Action for Children's Television, claimed South Park was dangerous to democracy. Takes like these no doubt only added to the show's viewership. The South Park phenomenon reached its peak in June 1999 with the release of the feature-length film South Park: Bigger, Longer, and Uncut. Being unrestricted from the confines of television allowed for more extreme language and content, which the creators wholeheartedly embrace. The film depicts a war between America and Canada, started over the former's belief that the latter corrupted their children via the entertainment exports Terrence and Philip. While it includes many depictions of murder, nearly 400 swear words, and Saddam Hussein penetrating Satan, I must say, it's an excellent musical. So much so, the song, Blame Canada, was nominated for an Academy Award, ultimately losing to Phil Collins and Disney's Tarzan. Now in its 23rd season, South Park continues to offend and entertain to this day. Now I'm considering this a sequel to the Simpsons phenomenon video. It's very interesting looking at the difference between the Simpsons and South Park in terms of the crazes they created. However, I think there are more similarities between the two, beyond of course being animated. Like the Simpsons, South Park began with a Christmas special of sorts, both generated their fair share of controversy, and have overcome that to instill themselves as cornerstones of pop culture. That culture, Western society, changed so much in the near decade between the show's airing that looking at music, fashion, or politics, it's clear to see that each in their own way reflected their time. South Park pushed the envelope because that was the style at the time, from Jerry Springer to pro wrestling, everyone was doing it. Personally, I have a ton of nostalgia for South Park in this period, however, unlike The Simpsons, I have grown out of it. I think that Trey and Bat are extremely talented, they can be very funny, and I think there is a place for edgy humor. I myself am a reformed edgelord, but the older I've gotten, the more weary I become in their political commentary. Parker and Stone pride themselves on not taking a stance. I get not wanting to be associated with politics, but the show's whole gimmick is commenting on current events and politics, with the moral more often than not being caring is stupid and both sides are dumb. But that's just me. Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't, and please, please, please consider becoming a patron over on Patreon, patreon.com/picksandportraits. As always, thank you so much for your interest in this channel, and thank you so much for watching.